Hey everybody. Today I would like to share with you my process of creating training data when you're using ChatGPT, Claude, or other AI models. Training data can be essential to your task whenever you're using an AI model because it can lead to even more efficient and accurate responses. You're essentially providing additional context and knowledge in order for the AI model to act as an even better partner to complete the task. The issue is that sometimes this training data isn't easy to get or find, so using ChatGPT to create this for you can lead to even more efficient results. So I'm going to walk through this task that I was looking at and how I created training data for the task. So for this, I was interested in how many aggregator or affiliate sites were in my search landscape. As an SEO, it's really important to understand what types of sites you're competing against online, whether those are direct competitors, search competitors, aggregators, and so on. So within my specific search landscape, I found that there was 150 competitors that I was competing with often online. And I'm interested in the percentage of those that are aggregators, so sites that are creating content designed to compare, review, and rank product or services. So I provided this information to ChatGPT and gave it the list of 150 competitors that I was interested in. So I'm just going to scroll through my chat really quick. And I'm asking it to tell me the percentage of these sites that are aggregator sites and then show me the list of aggregators versus non-aggregator sites. I wanted two buckets, the aggregators and non-aggregators. So without any previous context, ChatGPT already has some of this training data in its back end. So it already knows types of sites like Forbes, New York Times, and so on. And using this, it's using all this past information to complete this task. So it gives me the list of aggregator sites here as well, and non-aggregator sites here. So we have all of this list of 150 sites that I gave it. So sorry for the scrolling. And then here's the end data that it gives me. Total number of sites, 150 that I provided. List of aggregator sites, 16, non-aggregator sites, 134. Now, it's very important to, you know, like not just take this chat output as its word, you know, like you need to validate. So as I was looking through some of this information, I was thinking, you know, some of these sites do create some of that aggregator type of content, and I'm just not 100% sure that this is as accurate as it could be. So in another case, you would want to, you know, like provide some examples. Providing those examples and reference documents are important whenever you're using AI models to ensure that it is being as accurate as possible. So in this case, you could search Google and look for a list of aggregator websites. The AI overview is going to give you some lists. There's this tab as well, and then a list of 50 news aggregator websites. This is from 2022. This is also news site, so I'm not sure if it's going to be completely relevant to me. And then scrolling down, so you're starting to look at other sites. This could lead to, you know, like a lot of research and a lot of time looking into this, but there's got to be a better way. So within this other task, same task, but I'm starting it out a different way. So now I'm asking ChatGPT to create a list of 100 aggregator websites, and I'm also giving it the definition of what aggregators are. So an aggregator or affiliate website is categorized as a site that includes listicle content like top 10 payroll companies or best internet providers, and place this list of aggregator websites in a table along with their respective web domain. So I'm asking ChatGPT to, you know, like begin start our conversation with this training data. So one, it already has an idea of what the task could be. And then we're also creating that context window of aggregator and affiliate website. So it's already starting to think about some of this information or generate some of this information. So it creates this list of 100 sites. You know, you can take a look at some of this and check and make sure that some of these are, you know, like more aggregator sites. There are some that, you know, are kind of in the gray area with an aggregator website, and you could double check some of this and, you know, like tweak some of these as needed. But in terms of this case, we're just going to, you know, like double check that it's accurate and then ask what type of content do aggregators create. Be specific if we need to identify even more sites. So ChatGPT double checks this information, and then it creates this output of what types of content the aggregators create. So aggregators can create comparison lists, best of lists, guides, buying advice, deal aggregation, and so on and so forth. So it gives us all of this really good information. It gives us some refined lists as well. So like where it got things right, maybe where things that are more in that gray area as well. And now we're going to go back to the start of the other task. So again, I'm very interested in how many aggregator sites are in my search landscape. I have a list of 150 competitors in the search landscape that I'm going to send. And please help me organize those into two buckets, the aggregators and non-aggregators. So I provide the same list here. And it tells us, like what its process is going to be here. And then here's the categorization. So we have aggregators, and now there's a list of 32 and non-aggregators. So scrolling to the bottom here, and it gives us the percentage here again. So in the summary, of the 150 sites that I shared, we have 32 sites that are listed as an aggregator. And then within the other task without the training data, there were only 16 sites. So pretty big difference in terms of your search landscape over double the amount of aggregator sites. So again, just because we provided this data does not mean that it's better. Validation is still going to be very important and critical whenever you're looking this over before you're shipping this to a team member or a client. You want to make sure that it's right. So after looking through some of this, like non-aggregators, we have Amazon, REI, Reddit, North Face, eBay, so on. And then you have the list of aggregators here as well. And again, there's 16 more aggregators in this list than there were in the original list. And so after I was looking over this a little bit more, one that stood out to me was backpacker.com. So I went to this, just to check if ChatGPT categorized this as an aggregator. Let's just double check and validate some of this information. So I went to backpack.com and I found winter gear guide, and there's a bunch of other content list with guides, listicles, best of, and so on. So to me, that is an aggregator, which was not identified in the initial task as well. So it's still going to be critical to validate this information to make sure that ChatGPT is providing accurate information. However, providing this data and just asking ChatGPT for the data and the context beforehand did lead to a more organized and efficient list that I can trust a little bit more than I could before I had that training data. I would definitely recommend trying this with other types of categorization and themes if you want to analyze themes of keywords that you're ranking for and categories of your organic ranking terms, as well as different qualitative research that ChatGPT can help out with. Having that training data can be essential in making sure that your process is efficient and you're providing as accurate of an output as possible. Hope this is helpful. If you have any other ideas, I'd be definitely down to hear them. Thanks for watching.